all the things that are going on. One of them, actually two of them, being this right here. The
today.
Iowa Cubs. We have Randy Wehofer, the vice president, assistant general manager of our very own Iowa Cubs. You guys are busy today.
Yeah.
You know, one of the hottest days of the year, and you said, okay, here's what we're going to do. We're going to play two. What are you, Ernie Banks? Let's play two?
Well, we're trying to make up for one of the coldest days of the year when Nashville was here in April and we couldn't play at all. So we've got a special day-night doubleheader. So it's 2 7-inning games. First game's at 108.
Okay, so there's 7 innings.
Seven-inning games. First game's at 108. We'll clear the stadium. Second game at 7:08. Separate tickets for each game.
Okay.
The season ticket holders already have their tickets for both games.
All right.
This is a very rare, maybe first time ever, Friday afternoon game. We never play Friday afternoon.
Friday
we play
afternoon,
lots
right.
of day games,
yeah.
but never Friday because Friday night fireworks is what everybody looks
everybody
forward to.
Everybody waits for, yeah.
Begin the weekend. So people
well,
love day games.
This is very special then, yeah.
So start your weekend at 12. Just have a
Make
half a
day
of work.
Out of it.
Come
I
to the ballpark
it.
For 1 o'clock, and then we'll do our normal Friday night fireworks after the second game. We won't shoot fireworks at 3:30.
Boss, I have a meeting. I have a meeting downtown. I've got to go, right?
Maybe a couple of sparklers.
It starts
in
about
the
101, 108.
What time is your meeting? 108.
108 is when that meeting starts.
But always have a great time at Principal Park. And one thing that we really enjoy about Principal Park is your food. You guys have really stepped it up when it comes to food.
Yeah, our center plate partners and Chef Joe does a terrific job. And we're always trying to introduce a little bit something different. We have the new slaughterhouse sandwich this year, which is, I think, every cut of pork you can possibly imagine. All on one sandwich.
Oh, I forgot about that.
And that's been pretty popular. But you can get a great tenderloin. You know, that's kind of a thing around here, in case people haven't noticed, where, you know, people travel around trying to find the best tenderloin in Iowa. We've got a pretty good one at the ballpark, and the Cub Club food's really good too. You can come down to the ballpark even when the team's out of town and enjoy the restaurant 7 to 2 every day.
There you
Absolutely.
Go. Now, speaking of the Cub Club, you know, it is going to be warm. Are we going to be able to sneak in the Cub Club at all today at all? Or are we pretty booked?
For the day game, we make some exceptions because it's during the normal course of business to come in. If you're coming for lunch, it would normally be open from 7 to 2, so the Cub Club is open, and then the memberships will, the Cub Club memberships will be needed for the night game tonight in the
okay.
Cub Club.
Okay. Perfect.
Good
all
to
right.
know. All right, so it's been a very special season. You've had a lot of fun promotions going on. The big ring replica last night, but you also have a fun jersey giveaway that's happening this weekend.
Yeah, tomorrow night we're giving away a replica Iowa Oaks jersey, just like the ones the players have been wearing during the season.
Mm-hmm.
And Casey's is sponsoring that. It's their 50th anniversary also, so we've teamed
nice.
Up. We're giving away the replica Iowa Oaks jersey, the first 2,500 fans tomorrow night for the 7 o'clock game, and you can play catch on the field before the game and come out and do all that. So it's going to be another special night, and the team will wear their Iowa Oaks uniforms for the game tomorrow.
But everybody will match.
Everybody will match.
Showing them off a little bit. Now, we were joking about you might need to leave work a little bit earlier so you can go enjoy a great day over at the Iowa Cubs, but it's something for the entire family because we want the kids to get involved as well.
Yeah, and we'll have the fountain going for sure. So, you know, there's amazes me how many families think ahead being down in the bowl this year, and kids in their swimsuits and going out to the fountain.
Absolutely.
And splashing around in the splash pad and enjoying that right field corner. That's the best area for adults too. There's usually a little breeze going through there with a great view of downtown and get to see the game and all of that. So the fountain's a great way to beat the heat. We'll have water stations around the ballpark and make sure that we're keeping everybody hydrated and as safe as possible. And for the adults, a little trip through the walk-in beer cooler behind home plate is usually a good way to break the heat.
Cool down,
break the heat a little bit during
no
the game.
About now, one of the more popular ways to get down to Principal Park over the past year or two has been taking your bike and coming down there, and you're encouraging that, aren't you?
Yeah, Bike World has sponsored our new bike gate. We used to set up temporary fencing behind Gate C, behind home plate, in past for our Sunday afternoon pedal to the park promotion.
Right.
We made that a permanent part of the stadium, so it is an enclosed, supervised bike area. So we've got all sorts of places to lock up your bike. We encourage people to still lock it up, that we have people there, but we can't remember what bike that you rode in on as opposed
right.
to somebody else. So
bring your locks,
Bring your lock,
your cables,
but it's inside the stadium. There's someone there at that bike gate all the time. We've got specials on Sunday afternoon for an $8 ticket, and you get a water bottle or a koozie. Or for $15, you get your beer and a ticket, and when you ride your bike to the game. And any day during the season, for $5, you get a general admission ticket when you come with your bicycle and
really?
Park in the bike.
Well, that's a heck of a deal. I didn't know that.
Yeah, take advantage of
that.
Yeah,
something new we added this year, and then the bike parking is free as opposed to the car parking.
Hey.
Perfect.
Something to think about. All right, so we know what's happening this weekend. Let's talk about future games that we need to mark on our calendar.
Yeah, so we're really getting into the stretch run here. We've got this weekend against Nashville. The team goes to Memphis. We come back for just three games against New Orleans next weekend, and we'll have all the usual fun and excitement. And then the high school state tournament takes over Principal Park for the final week of July, and we'll have 28 games in 8 days to crown four champions in the state tournament. And then it's going to be August, and here we go, and we've just got a couple of homestands left after that. So it's a long summer that goes by really quickly.
Say, where has the summer gone so far?
So here we are. We're past the All-Star break, and we're right into the home stretch.
Okay, now if people are coming out and they're making plans to come out to the stadium later on today with the heat that we have here, which side of the stadium is probably the best for an evening like say afternoon, like this afternoon's 1 o'clock game?
Yeah, well, for the day game, there's going to be lots of sunshine around, but those top rows of the reserve grandstand are the place that you get some shade and overhang from the suite level. So ask to sit up at the top of the reserve grandstand if you want to be at the seat out of the sun.
And you can do that when you purchase your tickets.
Yeah, okay. And yeah, just ask for those rows at the top. The third base side in the evening game, the sun sets behind the third base side, so the home side behind the Cub dugout, the sun's at your back as you're watching the game and out of the sun. Last night, it looked like we had a full house from home plate to third base, and then from home plate to first base, it was a little bit lighter for the crowd last night.
People figured that out, huh?
People start to figure that out pretty well. But our mezzanine area under the press box, which is where we do picnics before the game, once the game starts, that becomes a general admission area. So if you've got young kids or it's accessible by the elevator, if you've got some folks that want to beat the heat, there's always a chance to go to the mezzanine, and there's usually a little bit of a breeze going through there.
That's
a good place to go take the kids or just to hang out an inning or two if you're feeling a little overheated.
Wonderful. And as you said, there's cooling stations and other opportunities.
We've got water
and
sunscreen and all sorts of first aid station. We've got people there to help if you're feeling a little off.
Okay. Love it. All right. So only a few games left. I can't believe it. Home games left. So you want to take advantage. You can make it an all-day affair all day today. If people want more details so they can mark all these dates down in their calendar, where should they go?
IowaCubs.com, our new responsive website. This year, we just launched that in the middle of May with a new look, so now it looks great and works on your phone and your tablets.
Perfect.
As well as it does on your desktop.
But day-night doubleheader starts a little after 1 o'clock today.
Lots of baseball today. That's a good thing
Perfect.
In my world.
And then fireworks tonight. Love it.
There
Thank you so
Randy.
Much. Great to
you
see
it. You. Thank you.
All right, 10 minutes past 8 o'clock.